Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanwat Cotrillo. We always talk about investment opportunities here on the show. And on Saturday, there's an event that aims to help young professionals learn more about investing. And here to tell us more about that are Carla Buan. She heads the Speakers Bureau of the Ateneo Alumni Association. And Jesus Jofileña, EVP for the Sales and Marketing Group of Insular Life Assurance Corporation. Carla and Jess, thanks for coming on the show.
Hi. Thank you
for inviting us.
Yes. All right. Okay, so there's this big event happening on Saturday called the Speakers Bureau. What's going to be happening there?
Okay, the Speakers Bureau program is an event by the Ateneo Alumni Association. It started in 2007, and since then we've been sponsoring several talks, such as the Marketing the Brand You, wherein we had the leading marketing managers from reputable FMCGs, and we also had an HR event wherein we had a mini job fair and some guiding tips for young professionals on how to apply. So this is a something wherein we want to help out the young professionals, you know, succeed in the corporate world.
Okay, and just to be clear, this is not exclusive for Atenistas, right?
No, it's open to all.
Right, okay, and when you say young professionals, what demographic is that exactly?
We're targeting 21 to 35.
Okay, all right. Pasok pa ka dyan. Good to know. I'm still a young professional. Okay, and so who will the speakers be on that night, and what will they be talking about?
Of course, we have Mr. Jess Jofileña as one of our main speakers, and we also have Harold Tan from Standard Chartered Bank, and Mr. Francisco Colaico, who is also one of the financial gurus here in the Philippines.
Okay, so just a lot of people think, okay, you know, this individual has a college education, perhaps, you know, from a very prestigious school. Do they still need to learn how to invest properly?
Well, I think conditions being the way they are today, you know, makes it actually quite important for young people and, you know, for anyone who wants to really get seriously involved in accumulating wealth or managing personal finance, you know, to really understand what's going on, and to have a better feel and idea of what the market opportunities are, and most of all, what the priorities are when it comes to managing your funds, because what we call investment can really span a range of opportunities.
Right.
And I think what's important is to have that financial roadmap so that you can be properly guided.
So what are the most common mistakes that young working professionals make when it comes to handling their money?
Well, I think the common mistakes are not for young professionals alone. I mean, they can happen to anybody.
True.
But I think partly I would say that, first of all, not being able to study or know enough about the opportunities that are presented to you. Sometimes there's a tendency to be overly dependent on peers, no, who may be excited about a certain investment opportunity but may not know as much as you do anyway about it. So some of it is really partly exuberance, you know, the desire for you to try to you know, get and earn money right away, where really investing is a disciplined and rational, you know, approach to wealth management.
Okay, and what are the factors that people need to consider when they're choosing different investment vehicles?
Well, I mentioned earlier about having a financial roadmap, no? And this is, I think, becoming more and more vital today, because I don't know if we realize it, but many more households have become multiple income households, meaning that, you know, if husband and wife are both working, then nobody has the opportunity to sit down and think rationally about how to plan their financial future. So I think it begins really with understanding and having a personal financial plan from which you can then derive not only your needs but the priorities when it comes to how you manage your funds and what you can do with it.
Right, and will you also be presenting solutions to these mistakes that we've talked about?
Well, probably opinions, recommendations. I wouldn't want to say real solutions because, you know, it's customized.
That's true.
People have to have a personal take on it according to their circumstances.
That's right.
Yeah, so I just want to add that it's not just the traditional bank deposits. So we want the young professional to know more about insurance, forex, and other investment outlets where they can put their money in.
Right, and it's not rocket science. I think once you are familiar with the way these things work, it's very doable, right?
Yeah.
That's right. And as I said, we hesitate to, for example, give formula prescriptions, because in my view, in my personal view, there's no such thing. It has to really be, once again, suited to the needs and circumstances of individuals.
Right. And just what topic will you specifically be covering on Saturday?
Well, my own career has been in the area of professional risk management, insurance. I guess I'll be covering much of that and showing how that relates really to wealth planning and financial management.
Right. So how many speakers will there be?
Three
speakers, and they'll speak for about how long each?
About an hour, or, well, 45 minutes.
Right, okay. And how can people sign up if this is something they want to attend?
Well, if they're interested, they can go to our website, the Ateneo Alumni Association website.